are very clear. So Francis and I are good friends. So thank you for having us here. But I'm going to talk to you a little bit about Carmel and what Carmel is. So the Carmelite spirituality is a very beautiful spirituality, and it places its emphasis on prayer. Prayer for the church, prayer for God's people, prayer especially for our beloved priests. And just entering into that depth of the heart-to-heart conversation with God, to live in the heart of the church in that prayer, as St. Therese would tell us. And most women Carmelites are cloistered because of that. They spend all their time concentrating on that union, bringing the whole body with them into the heart of Christ, and through Christ to the Father. We've been given the grace of a charism that blends that beautiful contemplative life with the active apostolate, which you'll hear more about later, but taking that love, that fire of the heart of Christ, and bringing it out to God's people in various ways. So we are blessed in that gift and that charism within the church. And so we're pleased to be here with you tonight, to be able to share with you in song, because song is a way of prayer. Right? St. Augustine would say, singing is praying twice. It's a way for the whole body and soul to enter into that divine spirit and into that love of Christ. And tonight we enter into it in a particular way as we prepare for Lent, right? And isn't it beautiful that God would ordain that this year, the first day of Lent, which is Ash Wednesday, falls on Valentine's Day, right? I believe it's beautiful because it's a God's message to us. He's saying, you are my beloved. Enter into this journey with me, because that's what Lent is. It's a journey with Christ. And as we hear in the book of Deuteronomy, the desert theme is vast throughout scripture, right? If you just follow it in three different passages from beginning to end of the Old Testament, he says that he bound Israel in the wilderness, right? In this vast wasteland of desert, right? That represents our sinfulness, our brokenness, our humanness that has a tendency to fall away from God. And then we get into Hosea and he says, now that I have this covenant of love with her, with you, I draw her into the desert. I lure her there, because it's there in the simplicity, free from distractions, free from diversions, that I can speak to her heart. God wants to have a heart-to-heart with us this Lent, and that's the beauty of it. And he does that through purification, right? We know that through our prayer, our fasting, and our almsgiving, are ways in which God purifies us of ourselves to bring our attention to him. And it's to bring our attention to him so that he can continue his love story, his love song, his love letter with us. Right? And then we hear in Isaiah, he takes that, and what happens in the desert? It becomes a flowery, blossoming desert, and the whole desert rejoices with the coming of Christ and his grace. And that's what he does with us. He takes our desert, he takes our wasteland, and he completely transforms it with himself into his glory and his joy and his love. Right? And then we get the privilege of bringing that up to all of God's people. Isn't Lent an exciting time? So we invite you to begin that preparation with Lent, or for Lent, with us tonight in this prayerful time, gathering all your thoughts, all your loved ones, bringing them here into this church with you, letting God's grace and his love fill you.
Thank you. I also suspect that there are people in the church today that have never seen religious. So for those of you that don't know us, we are women who have given our entire lives to Jesus Christ. Not of our own initiative, but in response to his call, to his touch of love. And we have handed our lives over to him so that other people may know his love. This night was organized according to human calendars, trying to get parishes dates, and we had no clue. We were just looking for a date that would work. That was our human thinking. But in divine ordinance, today is the day that all over the world, the Universal Church celebrates men and women who have consecrated their lives to God. February 2nd, presentation. It is also February 2nd, 1921, the very day that our beloved foundress, Mother Louise, put her pictures out at the reception, and her first companions began to live the Carmelite life today. In very uncertain times, she began living the Carmelite life, and within 5 years needed to flee the persecution of the Catholics in Mexico because the sisters were considered criminals because we had taken vows. We came to the United States. On this day, February 2nd, 1983, Saint John Paul II, by his own decision, established us as a religious community of Carmelite sisters who are active and who are grounded in our service to the people. Our mother house is here in the United States. We have been here for 90 years, quietly serving and quietly, gratefully growing. At the heart of our mission is our drive to share the love of the heart of Jesus with everyone we meet. And that mission takes three expressions. One is we are educators. We educate from preschool, we have 5 grammar schools, 2 high schools. We have a great commitment to retreat work where people can come aside and drink deeply from the heart of Christ. Some of you are coming with us next weekend, good for you. We have about 16,000 people come to us every year for prayer and solitude. And we have a commitment to health care, elder care. We have 3 campuses from independent living, assisted living, skilled nursing, palliative care. These sisters are educators, administrators, principals, nurses, lawyers, and Indian chiefs. But first and foremost and always, they are brides in Christ. Tonight we are singing for our own elder sisters, our sisters who have been faithful in their commitment, and we have urgent needs to keep them safe as they live out their consecrated life in a convent that needs repair. We are so grateful that you have come, and we have no doubt that the Holy Spirit will touch each one of you. You will wake up in the morning. Spirit has touched you. And if any of you are inspired to participate with us in any way, shape, or form, we are grateful. Before I turn the mic over, we want a word of gratitude to Father James, Father Peter, and also our anonymous donor who has provided a reception for you. They have chosen to remain anonymous, but Jesus knows who you are. And whoever you are, we are most grateful. We would like to end our evening with you in the church, because then we're going to go have the reception. So it's not the evening is not over, but conclude this time of prayer and music with a song of blessing. In a particular way for our priest, and gratitude for your gift to us, to your people, to each one of you who have come tonight. And every one of you have come with people who are in your heart and you love and you care about them. They're all included in this blessing.
Prayer with you, with a prayer for our country. And we especially, nothing warms the heart like our beloved hymn, God Bless America, by Carmelite.